A lot of you parents out there all across Ohio today, third grade students are taking their state reading achievement test, and starting next year, if students don't pass, they do not move on to the fourth grade. News 5's Karen Johnson now joining us with the impact that it could have. Hi, Karen.
Hey, Mike. You know, this new state law is causing some anxiety among parents and their little ones. Some parents say one test score should not determine whether their child moves on, but the state argues children who can't read by fourth grade have a greater chance of dropping out of school. Do you like books?
Yes.
What's your favorite book?
Toy Story.
He's just 4 years old, but Rylan can't seem to put down his favorite book.
Oh, it's very important to start, you know, the love of reading and at an early age.
That may be more important now than ever.
Okay, so we're going to keep reading and see if we can find out what. What are we looking for now?
By the time Rylan is in third grade, like these kids, he will be required to take a reading assessment test. These youngsters in Mrs. Schiaffi's class at Union Elementary School took it this morning. But next year, that test will carry greater weight.
Next year, the stakes will raise a little bit in terms of if our students do not hit a certain cut score, they will not be able to go on to fourth grade.
Based on previous year's test scores, the Ohio Department of Education estimates about 10,000 Ohio kids could be held back. Here at Lakota, administrators beg to differ.
Our numbers are rather low in terms of as we were to predict how many children this would affect. It would be a small amount, and it's our job to make sure that we know who those kids are and really work with them and work with their families.
Administrators here say they're already in the process of looking at the second graders, collecting data, and developing individual reading plans for the youngsters who need a little extra help preparing for the test next year.
Do you like that book?
Yeah.
Okay, now, there are a few exceptions to this new law. For example, students who have individualized education plans or those who have had less than 2 years of English as a second language, they would not be held back. Reporting live tonight in Westchester, Karen Johnson, News.